Welcome, everyone, to the next installment of God's Old Gamers Union Campaign, a major general difficulty, as I attempt to take at least 12 two-star units into Shiloh. Before heading out to Logan's Crossroads, I'll give you a brief overview of my camp. In camp, I used my two career points from First Bull Run to max out training. I topped off my units with vets to replace some of my casualties while letting others bleed down. I'm probably going to end up making around 20 new brigades at Shiloh to give me a total of between 33 and 36 units going into that battle, so I don't want to spend any more money than I need to before I get there. Two of my colonels were wounded at Bull Run, so I won't get them back until after Shiloh. I use my artillery extensively in the next two battles, so that's where I've spent some of my resources. I increased my ordnance rifle battery to 10 and converted one of my Napoleon batteries over to ordnance rifles. I was also able to bump up both of my Napoleon batteries to 10 guns, so now all of my artillery batteries have 10 guns now. With AI scaling set at 1.3, we'll be facing 21,226 soldiers and 41 guns. That's an increase of about 5,200 soldiers and 9 guns over the base scaling value. One thing I forgot to include in my mod settings video is that the game loads the mod files when it's launched. I use Notepad to make my changes, and although you can pop open Notepad to make the changes anytime you want, you'll have to completely exit the game and relaunch it for the changes to take effect. So if I were to change scaling back to 1 right now in the mod file, it wouldn't do anything until after I've exited the game completely and restarted, so keep that in mind. We will get a few of our units to 2 stars at this battle, but the majority of them won't get there until River Crossing. I don't think I do anything that's really out of the ordinary at Logan's Crossroads. Rather than crossing over the river, I just loop my infantry and supply wagon around the southern woods. We may or may not get into a small early skirmish before I eventually get my guys into place. You'll see that I use my skirmishers to provide rear cover for my artillery as they come onto the field. Then I'll move them around the perimeter until they are on the north side of the Confederates. While my skirmishers are on the move, as long as my units are not visible to the enemy, I will turn off firing for the infantry and my artillery units until everyone is in place, and then I'll open them all up at the same time. Eventually, I will move my units forward to reveal my position and get the Confederates to charge me, which will probably go bad for them. If a supply wagon gets out of place at any time, then I'll make a run at it. On Major General, I try not to move all of my artillery at once when in combat, so I always have guns ready to counter any charging units. So in most of this battle, you see me move my guns either one or two at a time. Of all the battles before Shiloh, I feel like this is the one that I could really crank scaling way up and let my artillery really pile up the XP. You have a ton of time. However, ammo supply is by far the biggest issue here when you increase scaling. Even if you steal the Confederate supply wagon, if scaling is higher than 1.3, you'll probably run out of ammo before you get to the end. I will be using the extra time at the end of the battle to increase stamina by marching my units back and forth across the field. It's not a huge gain, but when you're trying to get as many units to 2 stars as possible for Shiloh, it can make the difference between a unit making it or falling just short. I did a test in the past, not on this particular campaign, but on a previous campaign, to see what the difference is. So the total stamina of all 14 of my units in that campaign was 701 across 14 units, which is an average of 50.07. I then marched them until the time expired, and I ended up with 787 stamina points for 14 units, which is an average of 56.21. So on average, every unit gained an extra 6 in stamina here. I will be cutting that out of the video during editing because there's nothing to see there other than my guys moving back and forth across the field, so I don't need to bore the hell out of you. So I lost about 9% of my army, and the AI lost about 50% of his forces. A lot of his units shattered here, so he didn't get as many kills or captures. I had one colonel killed. So you can see that three of our units got their second star here. So we have some work to do at River Crossing to get the rest of them to their second star. So we will see you at that battle.